Hi everyone, I'm going to give you a really quick tour of my office. This is just because a bunch of you are curious about storage solutions and how I store things. Over in this corner, I have my desk, and it's actually up on bed risers because I wanted the same height as my crafting desk, which or crafting table, which you'll see in a minute. And I wanted them to share the same chair. So anyway, there's my little office area. Cable modem, earphones, my cameras in front. There's my iMac. And then I have the printer to the side. Just some random things. I've got my Epson PictureMate printer down there and a box full of cards I need to send out. That antenna in the corner there is for my ITV so I can watch TV on my computer. Over here is, this is actually an Expedit, I guess that's how you say it. Shelving or bookcase unit from IKEA, and I've just put the lovely desk attachment on this weekend, and I'm loving it because it has like under the table storage. So I don't necessarily use this as a desk; it's just to store things because I actually sit over here. But anyway, I've got my so you've seen this if you've been watching my reading my blog a long time, but it's this rolling cart that I got from Costco, and it has all my Stampin' Up! Cardstock in it, and I've labeled them by color. And then down below I have neutrals, the craft or whatever. And then over here I have some Stampin' Up! In colors, and then a bunch of just different paper cherry ink colors. So push that back under. Underneath, down in there, you can kind of see the cabinets. I have some Stampin' Up! Stamps, mostly older ones that I bought as an employee that I can't sell ever. I think I could possibly give them away, so maybe I'll have to have a little giveaway on my blog. Got my Cricut. I actually, to be completely honest, I was inspired to get this desk unit and attach it to the bookcase. Just to have somewhere to put my Cricut. So I no longer have to have it in the kitchen. So got my Cricut and my Cricut cartridges and my Making Memories white storage box back there. And then I have a clip it all, clip it up. What is it called? It's a clip it up. I had to look at the box. Just bought it yesterday. I thought I'd try this because I'm one of those people that if I don't have it out, I won't use it. So, I've put up all my acrylic stamp sets or ones that have the packaging. I've also got some ribbon, just random things, lots of alphabets back there. And then up here, I've got all the smaller items, buttons and stamp sets that don't have packaging. Lots of BAM Pop stuff, really cute stuff like, Caesar cupcake. Stamp sets you have seen, look like this Sassafras last one or Sassafras. Some random things. Okay, and then in the bookcase, I just have my albums, all my American Crafts cardstock, including I keep this on hand. You know what that is, right? Craft cardstock. I use way too much of it. Down below, I have these boxes that I also bought at IKEA, and only the right side are actually what they're labeled. Over here is just random stuff, like it's labeled like hardware and ribbon, but really, I don't have my ribbon there anymore. It's just randomness. But over here, this really is what it is. I've got stamps. That whole box is filled with paper tree ink stamps. Well, not filled. I don't have that many. Inks. I do have quite a bit of inks. Just, in there. And underneath are stamp sets that don't fit on the Clip It Up. Okay, here's the big desk that everyone's wondering about. I've got a shelf up there with the randomness. And then second shelf down, I just have, let's see, up here is mostly Stamp-O-Magic stuff, embossing powders. I have threads and buttons in this box, some ribbon, and then markers. Over here, I've got some smaller punches up here. You can kind of see them. Down here is just random adhesives. This is mostly acrylic blocks. Got some Stampin' Up! Ink pads, a lot of them actually. I need to break them out. And then all of my most used embossing or heat and stick powders. This is probably the most asked question, which is how I maneuver or how I attach my camera for when I'm filming on my desk. Basically, all the, well, I'll just explain it now. You have a two super clamps clamped to the shelf that's attached to the wall, and then a monopod with a ball head mount with a quick release on it that I attach the camcorder to. So, and then it just attaches like that, and you can see what I'm doing. So, there's this week's Make a Card Monday. So this is just like a total mess. I have my paper trimmer always on my desk. My stack of stamp and dimensionals. Just randomness. Like, seriously, this is how I work. Like sunscreen. Like, why do I have sunscreen on my desk? Randomness, old camera I'm gonna give to my sister. And then, oh, and I have two lamps. This is the lamp that kind of came attached to the desk. And then this is just a cheapy lamp from Walmart that I had from college. I have two lamps on when I'm working so that there's enough light. Over here, I've got some Hero Art stamps. Up above, it's just a bulletin board with some other things attached. I need to move over to the Clip It Up. Got some chipboard hiding back there. Chipboard. I've got my stack and store or stamp and store from Stampin' Up, just buttons and stuff. Some stamps and then a basket full of some paper items I really want to use. Down below are boxes of envelopes and note cards. Okay, in this closet is actually just another shelving unit with paper and stamps. Nothing special, like seriously, nothing special. You don't need to ask to see it. in here is just my little box of Big Shot items. I need to break these out. I really want to use this one, the Timeless Type Junior. I need to break that out. And my camera bag. And I wanted to say, make one note about my chair. It's the Steelcase Think, and it's my absolute favorite chair ever. You guys know I have back problems, and since I'm sitting in this chair a lot, I really wanted one that would have really great support. So I paid an arm and a leg for it, but I absolutely love it, especially because I use that chair at my computer desk and also at my crafting table. So it doubles up and I just roll it across and use it for both. So anyway, I don't know if that really helped any of you guys, but you guys wanted to see it. So anyway, thanks for watching. Catch you guys later.